At that time, they were called black music, race music, when I sung rock and roll. I was on RCA Victor before Elvis Presley, but they wouldn't put me on RCA, they put me on Camden. So when I would wear makeup, they would let me sing for the white girls. When I put on eyelashes and all that, they would let me sing. But when I went as a just straight dude, they wouldn't let me sing. They thought I wanted the girls. Uh-huh. So if I was came out straight guy, they wouldn't let me sing. But when I came out with all the makeup on and all the eyelashes and all the hair, they said, Richard is a good boy. I never was a good man, but I was a good boy.
Who is they that you're talking about here?
Some of the whites in Macon, where I'm from. I came from a little town. Yeah. You know, it was real prejudice back in that time. There was a lot of people that would love to have been flamboyant, you know, just like Kiss and Jimi Hendrix, which was my guitar player. He started out with me. Billy Preston, James Brown was my vocalist, Otis Redding. Beatles came with me. They started with me. Mick Jagger. All these people started with me.
So you really did have a dramatic impact and a great deal of influence on what would later become the mainstays of rock and roll music.
I was the architect.